very nice grapple. Nice lunge jump there. Usually can't do that. Going for the spark. Missed the grapple. Bad. Spark took way too long to notice the threat there, that was interesting. Going for the tank, maybe? Nope, blood hungry for Spark, okay. I think I would have gone for the tank. Spark was too high on my aggro list, you know, he knew I was coming. Not worth it. Support looks weak. Yes. A bit of an embarrassing grapple miss there, but she's recovering. Is she going to get shuriken grapple? Shuriken grapple, okay. Yeah, there we go. Time to flee. Good shit. See, depending on the ping gap in between you and your enemy, you can shuriken grapple pretty quick after a dagger grapple if you switch weapons. Sometimes you have to lunge and do it a little bit later. Good grapple. That's another thing there. Usually after an assassin grapples, or anybody really, you can get one assured melee hit in before the fight really begins. If you grapple somebody and you know they're gonna have a sliver after you finish the job, you can usually kill them anyway. Now that was nice. Perfect time. We lose a few things in this replays. A couple of sounds. I haven't been hearing Spark's teleports. That ain't natural. On one of those jumps, she should go for a shuriken grapple, but she seems to prefer her dagger. Now we're getting mean. Guess I should say he. Guy, but playing assassin. No. No. You see, unfortunately, I can't see health values in replay, so I don't really know if attacking people is a good or a bad idea in this system. They need to get stuff like that in. Eyed the veteran, but didn't go for it. Good choice. Good grapple. Oblivious Megabeth. Now, she could have got a shuriken grapple there. I noticed that she didn't go for it. She seems to not like shuriken grapples. Always sticks to the sword swipes instead. It's good use of juice. What level was that veteran? That veteran is level 4 and she is level 6. Okay, that would explain why she didn't feel scared fighting it like that. If they were even level, I would have ran away after that veteran got out of my juice ring. Good. I would have gone for a shuriken grapple right there. So again, this one seems to really like focusing on the dagger. The half-second weapon switch is too much of a risk for her. I'm just gonna keep on saying female, she, her, and all that, because it's assassin. Uh-oh. Oh, that'll be it. Is she running massive air? Can I see that? Nope, I can't see products. Poopy. Might be running massive air, though. Lovely thing about commandos is progenital and healing in general heals them faster, because I cannot tell you how many times I've been a veteran, and it just takes eons for that health bar to fill. Opting for swings on the tank instead of grapples. Good choice, because jetpacks are a pain in the arse. I'm sure this one is keeping track of ping as well, knowing who's good to grapple and who's good to swing. That's a very important thing to do as commando. I like the high five. A little bit of psychological effect there. Pissing off Spark, making him play worse. Good grapple. Ooh, health inverter on a veteran, that's new. I would not recommend health inverter on a veteran. The lifesteal's only, what, 13% these days, and he's gotta hit you with a hot seat. Now, if he skid row throws you with health inverter on, that's gonna heal him about 40% of his health, maybe? Let's say he's level 15, he'll do 1425 to you. So, he's gonna get... Actually, that sucks. Don't use health inverter. The only way a veteran gets a good amount off a health inverter is if he hits you with an ejector. I'd recommend it for high rate of fire pros. Tank, gunner, things like that. But generally, I wouldn't use it at all. That was a good grapple break. You'll notice that she waited until right before the damage was inflicted. Could have used the juice at any point, but held the veteran in place for the maximum amount of time without taking damage so Mega Man could shoot the veteran. Very nice move. I heard that tank coming. She didn't. A lot of this game has to do with sounds, footsteps, voices. One of the scariest things about the game is the fact that you talk when you buy a skill. It can practically give you away in an ambush. Buying a tab lining too. I know she's not buying Fujibots. We can stop right before this fight, but it looks like it's gonna be good. She'll probably flee. Alright, she's fallen behind the gunslinger, but damn, has she got kills. Feeding quite a bit. Now, unless she's saving for the Annihilator or plans to buy a Bouncer, I think she should have bought Fujibots in the base before she left. Oh, we gotta quit. Yep. Okay. We're at the 8-minute mark here, and support has only got 10 bot kills. I know that he uses a shotgun, I know that he, has a hurt beam, but that's just still too low. We also see Tank at 15 bot kills. Assassin's only got 13, but Assassin has been doing a damn fine job of killing people, so I'm a bit more lenient on that. Assault needs to pick up. So, really what we're seeing here is Gunslinger's doing superb. Assassin's doing great on kills. Everyone else is kind of so-so, and Red Team's feeding. Megabeth is doing her job on Red Team, but as a slow class with a sharpshooter and a fed lithe class like the Assassin going about, she's kind of shafted. And now that they don't have any healer, things are looking bad. And we're back. Actually just had a talk, if you saw that Steam message, with the guy that I'm reviewing here, Sir Bob Lannister. Just making sure I had consent for the video and all that. I decided to do something a little different today and review somebody else's game instead of my own. This guy seems to know what he's doing with Assassin, so I took the demo. Replay system still has a lot of kinks to work out, but it is cool to see stuff through other people's eyes, see if they make decisions different from you, and things like that. Anyway, back to the game. Let's see if we can fix that. There we go. Oh, that's ballsy. Knows when to quit, that's good. You might be wondering how she's following Spark so well. Well, when you're blinded, like I said in the Leo video, you can still see health bars and things like that. So, if you know about the game, blind really ain't doing you that many favors. It's honestly just a half-second disorder, really. Just screws with people's heads more than anything. What's best about blind is the accuracy. Spark was a high enough threat to wait like that. Now see, I've been watching that tank does not have high reaction time in this game. Good grapple on Spark, kind of unlike how Churro? Nope, she didn't see it. I'm pretty sure there was a Churro from a dead robot right there that she jumped over. But yeah, if I was fighting that tank, I'd totally go for double grapples almost all the time. There she goes. Now, you're gonna want to watch that again. She didn't see the tank. She heard the tank. Footsteps are very important in this game. People getting mad. Your ping will be hell to you. You'll think you're in the middle of the air, but they'll think you're on the ground. And it matters what they see, not what you see. That's why it's very important in a game to get a feel of who's going to win grapple fights against you and who's going to lose them. And you have to play accordingly. Grapple? Nope. That was a really weird charge by the tank. Whoa! Looks like she had a bit of a bounce and launch.
Take care,
at level 15, that assassin back grapple does about the same damage as Skid Row throw, about 200 less damage. Okay, now that was weird. That should have been a back grapple. She scooted over to the front for some reason. Shuriken grapple? Nope, he's low health. I didn't notice the double ones. Oh, that sucks. Gunslinger, a bit late to the party, and with no trigger-happy headshots. That's a poor decision. Gunslinger could have stood right over here on this ledge and shot the crap out of the Annihilator. And we're back. Same ledge, too. Bot metabolizing IC. Oh. Not in ejector range, so good choice for the grapple. Again, that Mega Beth's a bit of a slow one, so... probably could have started swinging without fear of the grapple. Some people know to weapon switch very quickly and go for a grapple. Others don't. If you find one that doesn't, and they're not holding their grapple weapon, it's open season. Beat the crap out of them. Oh, that's a bouncer. There's a good jump to avoid the bouncer grapple. You see bouncers lunge for their first grapple, and that's the one that'll actually throw you to the ground. Otherwise, they just try to swing at you. You can play patty cake with a bouncer, just constantly walking backwards and forwards, and you'll never get hurt while you beat the crap out of them. Once this fight is done, we're gonna get another scoreboard up. I see, why doesn't Spark high-five back? Be a sport. Alright, you see those circle jumps there? Definitely running massive air, so now we know. Ooh, that was nice. I wonder if that was luck, or if she happened to, be told by a teammate over a mic. What? Man, I hate scramblers. Use that scoreboard like I said. We're gonna watch that bouncer too. Okay. So, the game's been going downhill since support left. Feeder's gonna be feeders. Now, this is an interesting case in that if you manage to play the game bad enough, you're actually a complete negative factor to your team. That's just how MOBAs work. It's technically better for this Hotshots team that their support doesn't exist, because if he was 0-5 when he quit, he could be all the way to 0-11 now. So it's an interesting way to look at things. Assault here is 0-5, but it's been 13.5 minutes, so it's not too bad. Again, his bot kills are still deplorable. Lannister could be killing more bots, but she's been on the kill scene all day, and considering that she's up in levels, I can't argue with that. Other than that, Gunslinger's doing her job. Megabeth, while not doing good in fights, is recognizing her purpose as a bot killer. Megabeth is very good at killing bots thanks to rockets having infinite range, and Derby Disku. Then we've got the veteran doing his Falcon spam thing to make sure he tags all his bots. Tank should definitely have more bot kills, but at least he's clearing the field a little bit. The enemy Megabeth is doing her job at bots, but just like Diesel, Bane is having a lot of problems because of all these lithe classes and headshots. Double sharpshooter with a commando that's hungry for you, when you don't have a support, is just an ugly position to be in. And we're back. Looks like that bouncer's gonna go for Beth. I can hear the bouncer behind. Alright, bouncer's going for someone else now. I can still hear his footsteps. Here he goes. Looks like he grabbed a veteran. Or veterans got ripped in. So unfortunately, that makes that $1,000 purchase a complete loss. She should get those juice boxes, don't let go to waste. It's an interesting thing about Tank, you know, he does the charge Death Blossom, it hurts like hell, but then he's stuck there, you know? That charge has got like a 7-second cooldown at rank 4, Death Blossom's on a 6-second cooldown. He's really an assister or a finisher. He doesn't do things on his own. Yeah, there we go. Juice to get rid of the fire. Now, considering the teammates and the fact that you could have used shurikens, I think I would have stayed around and shot him with my juice shuriken. Or at least found a bot to shoot. Maybe go into the jungle and use churros because I'm not scared of the enemy. I believe gremlins spawn about once every 30 seconds, starting at like the 20 or 30 second mark. I try to go upstairs and find the gremlin every 30 seconds if I hit tab and see I'm on a minute or a half minute. Now this is really scary. Rocket turret, LOS, lots of enemies. Let's see what the level difference is. So she's level 12, these guys are 11 and 10. And with no healer, it's one of the reasons she's being so ballsy. That is some obsessive high-fiving. I don't know why. I kind of like it, kind of don't. You gonna get an ejector here? Someone's bored. Could have done a shuriken grapple there, but with the tank around, it might have hurt too bad. All damage while you're grappling or being grappled outside of the grappler source is reduced by 50%. If you grapple a jackbot, the jackbot still takes 100% damage. But even at 50%, a tank focusing you is painful. See, I would eject that Fuji. I mean, she's got extra catch. But she seems reluctant to eject that Fuji. I figure it's gonna save me time, I'm gonna get juice, I'm gonna get back to the front line, I got no other use for the money. She's back in her base, but she's not buying Fuji bots. If I had spent that long on killing that Fuji, I probably would have lunged back to the base and bought one. you'll find light classes are the ones more likely to buy bots unless you're trapped in your base, because they can get there the fastest, they lose the least from going to buy them. It's really nice to get money from your bots when they kill stuff. Sorry, that was me shaking the mouse. I would juice that rocket turret. I'd lunge behind them, make sure I'm not noticed, and then juice the rocket turret. The enemy doesn't come off as a threat to me at this point. I just focus on the objective and get the game over. Which is what bot killing can do. But again, totally has enough money to buy a second juice. So, I just have at it. Start expunging all my cash at this point. I didn't catch what damage source that was. Here you see that the jackpot, while you can jump over the grapple, if you're too close to it, you can't jump over it. Three missed grapples, oh boy. Grapple break. Now this assassin is just having all kinds of fun with massive air, hopping around like a mad woman. That was an odd pause, considering that there was a tank there to kill. Okay, let's pause right there. You see what these two were doing? These two people are fighting over chicken cantor. I would recommend that you never do that. Chicky Cantor's buff is incredibly insignificant right now. I hope it gets buffed in the future. But you gotta sit there, you gotta fight it. There's no point in shooting the chicken, he doesn't take enough damage, so you have to grapple it after its AoE stun that dazes the chicken. And it does, like, what, 25% health recovery and, like, a small base health increase? Okay, tank's getting too close. Go away, tank. Shoot. Creeping me out. But yeah, don't fight for the chicken. That was a really cool jackpot wave. Just saying. This is actually really nice. I like this. But we should get back to the game. Assassin. Where are you, buddy? There you go. Rook doing his best to kill jackpots, but it just ain't gonna cut it. This game's been over. We'll look at the final score. Astro definitely has high ping if he's going to complain about grapple so much. Any taunts? There's a taunt. Any more taunts? No, there we go. Not sure how I feel about taunting after a game like that, considering...
That'll wrap things up from Loco Muco Arena. Monday Night Combat would like to thank our fans for their continued unwavering support.
This is a good video to show Feeder versus Fed. You know, Bane here had the right idea. When things get ugly, and you're not winning, just kill bots. Just focus on what you can control. If you can at least minimize the level gap, you can at least hold out until 25 minutes, jackpots start spawning, and then you can work with them. And when you get to the point where everyone's level 15, there's only a skill gap, there's no longer a level gap. So that was Sir Bob Lannister, which I guess I'll say again, is a guy. I keep on saying she just because he's playing assassin. And I might do more videos like this, not sure. But it's definitely fun to watch what happens through someone else's eyes and see the choices they make. See you next time.